Dear friends, in class 7, we are studying 4 chapters, simpler equations, and in exercise 4.4, we have second question, solve the following. In that, first is, a teacher tells a class that the highest marks obtained by a student in her class is twice the lowest marks plus 7. So this is the condition given to us. Let us try to find the marks. The highest score is 87, what is the lowest score? So, let us try to find the solution to this. What is the lowest score? So let the lowest score be x. Let the lowest score be x. It means twice the lowest marks is equal to 2 into x, that is 12. This is twice. Then twice the lowest marks plus 7. Next condition is twice the lowest marks is plus 7. Plus 7 is equal to 2x plus 7. So this is the condition we have got. Now we are given that the highest marks obtained by a student is twice the lowest mark plus 7. So this is the highest marks. So highest marks are 2x plus 7, and we are also given the highest score is 87. It means these two must be equal. So as per given condition we can say that 2x plus 7 is equal to 87. Now, in order to solve this, let us transpose the term which does not contain a variable to the right hand side. So here 7 is a term which is not having x in it, so we have to transfer it to the right hand side. To transpose 7 plus 7 to RHS. So we will get 2x is equal to 87 minus 7. Now 87 minus 7 is 80. So 2x is equal to 80. Now divide both sides by 2. Divide both sides by 2. So you will get 2x upon 2 is equal to 80 upon 2. So these two eliminates with these two. 80 divided by 2 is 40. It means x is equal to 40. We have already taken the lowest score is x. It means lowest score is 40. Dear friends, let us see the next question. Second question is, in an isosceles triangle, now try to understand. Isosceles triangle means a triangle which has two congruent sides. So these two sides are congruent sides. In an isosceles triangle, the base angles are equal. So, if two sides are equal, then the very important property of isosceles triangle is base angles, that is these angles are congruent, or angles opposite to congruent sides are congruent. This is very important property of the isosceles triangle. The vertex angle is 40 degree. This remaining angle, vertex angle, is 40 degree. This is what is given to us. What are the base angles of the triangle? What are the base angles of the triangle? Now, what we are going to do? We will consider this figure as isosceles triangle. Let triangle ABC be an isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle. Now, in this, base angles are congruent. It means angle B is equal to angle C. Angle B is equal to angle C, that is equal to, let this be also equal to x. Now angle A is 40 degrees, this is what is given to us, angle A is equal to 40 degrees. Now one more property is there of the triangle. Sum of interior angles of a triangle is always 180 degrees. We have very important property of the triangle. So we know that this you will prove when in some elder classes, 8th standard, 9th standard, you have to prove that sum of interior angles is 180 degrees. Now here, for the time being, we are directly using the result that sum of interior angles of triangle is 180 degrees. Sum of interior angles of triangle is 180 degrees. It means at angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degrees. Now angle A is 40 degrees. Angle B is X. Angle C, base angles are equal. So if this is X, the other angle will also be X. It means angle C is X. So this is equal to 180 degrees. Now we have got 40 plus X is equal to 180 degrees. Therefore, we will get 40 plus X is 2X is equal to 180 degrees. Now transpose 40 to the right hand side. The reason is 40, this term does not contain X. So transpose 40 to RHS. So we will get 2x is equal to 180 minus 40, that is equal to 140. So 2x is equal to 140. Now divide both sides by 2. Divide both sides of the equation by 2. So we will get 2x upon 2 is equal to 140 upon 2. So this 2 eliminates with this 2. 140 divided by 2 is 2 7s are 14. So x is equal to 70 degrees. Thus, base angle of triangle is 70 degrees. Dear friends, next third question is, Sachin scored twice as many runs as Rahul. Together their runs fell too short of a double century. It means their total runs were too short to double century. Double century means 200 and too short to double century means two runs less than double century, that is 198 runs. How many runs did each one score? So let the Rahul's runs scored solution, let runs scored by Rahul dx. Now Sachin scored twice as many as Rahul. It means Sachin's score is equal to 2x. Now together their runs fell too short of a double century. So too short of double century is equal to 200 minus double century, too short. So too short of double century is 200 minus 2, that is equal to 198. Now the condition given is their runs fell too short to the double century, means together their runs are 198. So as per given condition, we have got 2x plus x is equal to 198. So 2x plus x is 3x is equal to 198. Now this problem is very easy. Divide both sides of equation by 3. So this is equal to 3x upon 3 is equal to 198 upon 3. So this 3 is reducible with the 3, and 198 is also divisible by 3. You will get 3 6 18 and 3 6 18. It means x is equal to 66. Thus, Rahul scored 66 runs and Sachin's score is 2x. So score of Sachin, 2x is equal to 2 into 66. That is 2x. 2 multiplied by 66. That is equal to 6 2s are 12, 1 carry, 6 2s are 12, 132 runs. It means Rahul's score is x. Thus, Rahul scored 66 runs and Sachin scored 132 runs.